ask what's one of the worst things you've done to a person, physically or mentally? So yeah, you can. This is going to be gross and it's embarrassing. And I know that, like, it doesn't matter that it's embarrassing to me. What matters is that it's wrong. So I'm prefacing this with, this is wrong and you shouldn't do this to people. And if you find yourself relating to what I say, then maybe you should get some help. That's all. So I always view relationships as like mental chess. So I was always doing everything that I said and did was planned and thought out to get reactions and to like get people to do certain things. So I push people to really bad places. Like I would push people mentally to very distraught places, to very traumatized places, to like, I would pull them into their trauma, like I would figure out their trauma and their triggers, and then I would slowly dose them with their triggers and their traumas to put them into fight or flight mode so then I could have more control over them. This is terrible. Oh my god. One person I had so stuck on me that he ended up sending me like $150,000 during the pandemic, and he was also like not getting anything from me, and I was like telling him to kill himself, and I was being really mean and making him cry all the time, and I would like lie to him, and then I would like give him like doses of like what he wanted, and but like I was just mostly just really abusive. Like I was like just like, you're just such a piece of shit and like nobody cares about you and all of that, because I was just wanted to keep him so I could keep using him. And I think that that complete disregard is like just like the worst thing that I've done, like mentally, is that all of that that I just explained. I also admit there was like one point in my life where I thought that this was cool. Like I thought that like manipulating people and like having the ability to like implant thoughts into people's brains by like suggestive like thought was like cool, and I liked doing it, and now I feel disgusted and I don't think that it's right. I know that people are probably gonna like be like, wow, you're a piece of shit, but that's why I'm on here, that's why I'm talking, that's why I'm trying to be honest. So yeah.
Out here, don't get caught up in this street shit. You hear me? There's a lot of young women out here dying more than usual. You know why? Because they set niggas up. So all you young women out here, once you line a nigga up, once you set a nigga up to get robbed, once you leave that side window open so them niggas can creep into the house, you a street nigga. Ain't no changing that. Once you jump in that lane, little mama, you a street nigga. So let's stop the dumb shit. There's a lot of young women out here on some dumb shit. Oh, and all the rappers tell you in the raps, I got a shorty that's going backdoor you. I got a girl that's going backdoor you. Let me tell you something, little mama. That backdoor will lead to another door, the front door to heaven, when they blaze this shit out you and shoot your fucking wig off. Stop the dumb shit. All right?
23-year-old Shabria Furlow, known to most as Bria, was a beloved mother of two beautiful children and a friend to many, was sadly shot and killed by an unnamed individual that she was believed to have known since her childhood days growing up in Blythe, Arkansas. Now, according to reports from the St. Louis Police Department, at around 3:20 a.m. on January the 11th, 2022, Bria, along with four males, whom two were armed, attempted to rob or commit a home invasion on the unnamed male while he was visiting St. Louis at the 300 block of Lancaster Road. It was said that upon approaching the home, gunfire was exchanged between the two parties, and unfortunately, 23-year-old Shabria was struck and killed. Christopher King, a spokesman for the St. Louis County Prosecuting Attorney's Office, told sources that upon review of their initial investigation, that there was no crime that was committed, that it was legitimate self-defense. The men that were with Furlow were not caught, so they don't quite know what the motive behind the confrontation was at this time. They did say that the unnamed shooter was cooperating with authorities.
A hail of gunfire outside a North St. Louis County home leaves a woman dead. Fox News' Kelly Hoskins is live with the exclusive security video that captured the tense moments of that shooting. Kelly.
Well, Jasmine, we're right outside St. Louis County First Precinct, where investigators are continuing to search for the gunman. It's unclear what led up to the tragedy. Meanwhile, residents are calling for the violence to end. This is exclusive video caught on security cameras in the area, where a St. Louis County woman was shot and killed from bullets started flying outside her home. As you can see, someone turns around in a yard and fires shots right at someone, and then that person returns fire. Bomberita Automotive Group Skyfox was over the scene in the 300 block of Lanshire Road in North St. Louis County, where the tragedy all unfolded around 3 Tuesday morning. In the video, it appears multiple people were exchanging gunfire from outside the victim's home on the front yard. We are told the woman was inside the home.
Now to a case so bizarre, some are calling it a made-for-TV crime that landed these four people, behind bars. It happened after police say a man was invited to the home of a woman that he was talking to through a dating app website.
Things are quiet now inside the Reserve at Dexter Lake Apartments. But Monday, a man went to this unit when things turned terrifying.
That sounded like some TV stuff. Yeah, it sounded like Netflix.
It was an alleged robbery plot that sounds like it was made for TV, but this was all too real.
This all started when the victim says he met a woman online through a dating app, essentially throwing caution to the wind, deciding to meet at this apartment complex. The victim, who thought he was getting a shot at love, would find himself being shot at several times.
I'm not surprised, because things happen all the time, especially around here.
Not wanting to go on camera, this neighbor was still shocked.
It's crazy.
Hearing police were investigating an alleged dating app kidnapping involving one of his neighbors. Jasmine S. Williams is accused of being the face of this elaborate crime. Detectives say Williams, while online, invited the victim over. He was ambushed, he describes, after going inside her unit. Three more people, identified as another woman also named Jasmine Williams, Nadia Townsend, and Trevor Keys, were lying in wait. The victim says he was robbed, pistol whipped, and held hostage while the four accused, quote, started arguing over what to do with him. He says he was put inside the trunk of a car before being moved to the back seat and driven away. After hearing one of the alleged abductors say they were going to, quote, torture and kill him, the victim says he made his move, running for his life while also dodging bullets.
And I'm not surprised just because of the world we live in.
A worldwide web meetup that ended with the victim in the hospital and four others being taken away in handcuffs from the very apartment this all allegedly started from.
Hello.
Who are you looking for? Who? Who is there?
My name is Erica.
You got the wrong house.
Okay, fine.